It was a great night, obviously, for Dublin and Dublin hurling people, Tomás. But what about Kilkenny? In your view, were there any indications that this might be on the cards?
I think there were. This, for the first time, maybe in 2013, maybe their National League. I mean, they won a National League title. I didn't think personally that they'd played as well as we've seen over the years throughout the league campaign. But they did manage to get a couple of results that maybe got them over the line. They won a league title. And I suppose maybe the warning signs were there in the first match against Offaly, conceding the four goals. I know there was two of them were presents, but they still, you don't see Kilkenny giving away four goals that easily. There were periods in the game where they struggled. So the form coming in wasn't absolutely fantastic. But you must look at this in the basis of they've contested every All-Ireland since 2006. The injuries are mounting, right? There is mental fatigue there. There's no doubt about that, right? And like the Leinster Championship campaign has got a lot harder now than it has ever been in the past. And I think timing-wise, coming into a championship, maybe they get their timing a bit wrong because they want to win every match they go to play. And some of their key players didn't get a rest over the winter period. And there seems to be a bit of tiredness, mental fatigue. And it is interesting, like we've seen the hurling championship to date, the teams that are coming with the biggest freshness and I suppose the appetite for it, we saw with Limerick, we saw with Offaly the last day, and now we're seeing it with Dublin, you know. And the Division 1 league has made it very, very competitive, that it's like a championship. And yeah, you're wondering, is it the best preparation coming in for the likes of Kilkenny then?
Yeah. But you see, Joe, it's Limerick weren't in Division 1 A, and neither were Dublin. They're in the finals. What about Dublin?
Well, I suppose to understand the importance of the victory to Dublin, you have to see where they were coming from. Like 2 years ago, Anthony's there now 5 years. 2 years ago, they won the league. Terrific display against Kilkenny in the league final. They got to the All-Ireland semi-final. People forget that. They were in the All-Ireland semi-final and ran Tipperary very, very close. Then last year, you know, they put all the emphasis on the championship last year, were relegated in the league, had a big psychological effect on them. Then we had the meltdown in Portlaoise that night we all expected. We expected Dublin to do that night, but they did last night. Yeah. And then after that, Bellew and Clare, they were absolutely abject against Clare. So big criticism of the team afterwards. Questions whether Anthony'd stay on. He stayed on, they came back, won Division 1B of the league this year, and then lost again very badly to Tipperary. So then we went down to Wexford to see the start of the championship. They drew, but weren't good. But from then on, you know, they have built up the momentum. Mm. The drawn game, people thought, has gone. So last night was the night for Dublin. And to see, the way they played last night, the confidence which they played, the method with which they played, was in total contrast to what we saw in Wexford.
Okay.
And, it just shows, if you get matches in summertime and you have good management, what can be achieved.
All right. Well, we asked you to contrast maybe the two performances. And Tomás, you looked at the defences.
Yeah, I think the game plan for Anthony Daly's men last night was to defensively, obviously, not to concede goals, be strong at the tackle. And here you see Owen Larkin trying to get through. And that's one of Kilkenny's strength. They break the first tackle, they get through, they get 2-1, and they set up goal chances. There was none of this last night. In defence, to a man, they were absolutely fantastic. None better than Liam Rush at centre-back. Here you see Gaunty, he doesn't get to attack it. But when you watch this, there's Walter Walsh. There's nothing else in his mind but to get in across the end line. Plenty of numbers back. And here we circle all the numbers back in defence. I think there's 7 Dublin defenders. You've three Kilkenny attackers. So defensively, they got it right. And they never left. I think there was no goal-scoring chance for Kilkenny last night. And that's very, very unusual. Peter Kelly. And then they had the composure when the time was needed, you know, not to be just pucking balls for the sake of pucking them. Take this in contrast. Here we circle 3 Kilkenny guys. There's 1 Kilkenny or Dublin guy going for the ball. The Dublin guy gets out, and look at this. He just turns his marker. And this is what I'm saying about the fatigue and maybe with the legs. Gets it across. And here we see Dazio Callan. Look at the numbers of the Kilkenny guys getting back there. There was a time, Des, when you would not get a strike and goal, not alone get the ball into your hand here. It's saved. It comes back out. And look. This is Danny Sutcliffe. It just comes so easy. He just sidesteps Tommy Walsh. And I mean, there was a time, if you were trying to sidestep Tommy, you'd probably end up in the front row of the stand in Leash at that stage.
Or the back row,
whatever, you know. I mean, it's just a kind of a contrast in style. That defensively, they got it right last night. There was holes in the Kilkenny defence.
And we'll keep that contrast element going, Ger. you're contrasting use of possession.
Yeah, well, the pattern of the game was set right from the very, very start. And it was Dublin who dictated it. Now, ignore the personnel here. Just watch what they're doing. You know, the kind of ball that Kilkenny defence were and the Kilkenny goalie were delivering was absolutely so untypical Kilkenny. You know, a high, aimless ball, all aimed at Walter Welsh, the corner forward, because he had done the last there. And the ball was out near the sideline, so that if even he got the ball himself, he was going to be easily contained. The first four balls came down to him, he lost them and he lost confidence. Now look at that ball. How untypical of Tommy Welsh is that? To hit the ball, an aimless ball, into a space where there is absolutely no kicking man. Now look at Dublin. The diagonal ball. Kept two forwards inside the 21, used the diagonal ball to open up the space, had dragged the Kilkenny defence out of position. Now, there's the ball over, that's O'Callaghan. Here he is at right corner forward, takes on his man and puts the ball over the bar. Now, at the other time, he moved across, we saw him at the other side of the field, at the other corner. Here he is now at the far corner. Wins the ball again. Now, I know you don't look at Kilkenny here, look at the tackling. He's so slow and so untypical, as I say, of Kilkenny, but still at the same each time, it shows that Dublin had a great plan. Yeah. 2 forwards inside the 21 yard line, keep him inside and keep him moving across the line, but not come out. Yeah. It was really, really well set up. But a word of warning to Dublin. They abandoned this in the second half completely. There were no diagonal balls. They didn't keep the 2 corner forwards inside in the second half, and as a result, they were struggling.
All right. Well, it sets up a heck of a final, doesn't it?